Hiya, Bobby.
Hi, Ken.
You want to go for a ride?
Sure, Ken.
Jump in.
I'm a Bobby girl in the Bobby world. Life in plastic, it's fantastic. You can brush my hair, undress me everywhere. Imagination, life is your creation.
Come on, Barbie, let's go party.
I'm a Bobby girl in the Bobby world.
Hey guys, Pastor Mill here with another video. Now today this video will be done right here on the old comfy couch. Anyhow guys, this video will address a few things, okay? This will address the scoffers who you always see in the comment page. You can't judge. The Bible says, do not judge. We even hear Robbie say, do not judge. Now what I'm gonna do is prove it by line for line, precept upon precept, a little here, a little there, just the way the scriptures are supposed to be read. What does the precept mean? What does the line by line mean? What it actually means is that there's a formula of truth in the scriptures and it all travels right on down through. So if you want to know what one particular line actually means, you're going to have to read other parts to back up that verse, so you can get the full meaning of what it's saying. In other words, one verse backs up another verse, backs up another verse, then you understand the precept and the whole idea of what the scripture is trying to speak. You can't just pick out one line and go, that's it right there. So with that said, let's address Robbie and Siren in this video and show them that they have it all completely wrong. Jesus says, you can judge. Let's talk about it. I'm going to show you a clip of Robbie, his thoughts and his interpretation of what the scriptures mean. Heard it before, right? It says, judge not, or you too shall be judged. Remember that scripture, okay, in Matthew? I'll point that out now, and I'll let Robbie read it out to us.
There's a pastor on here who really comes at me in a really aggressive way, and so...
So, Robbie, according to you, I come at you very aggressive. No, I say I come at you with solid truth that your itching ears don't want to hear.
Oh, all I did was... Now listen, the Bible's beautiful. It's a cookbook, but I still see it as a book.
This paper right here is shit. It's fucking shit.
It still is written by man, after all, but beautiful words in it.
And this paper right here is shit. It's fucking shit.
My relationship with God is in my heart. It's my experience and all that kind of stuff. Yeah, Shay, I think you're right. They don't want to understand.
So, Robbie, you say we don't want to understand. You agree with this individual, Shay. The issue here is, haven't you had your channel for 10 years? I'm not too sure. And you named it Save Robbie. So that means you've been a Christian or following Christ for the last 10 years, as long as your channel's been going. Am I correct? In that case, why are you, as Apostle Paul would say, still drinking milk when you should be eating solid foods by now? Same thing as an infant. You should grow out of that stage of sin that you're in. Now let's read what the scripture says about those who come to Christ and actually receive Jesus as their Lord and Savior. Let's read 1 John chapter 3 verse 9. Very illuminating. It will prove my point. No one who is born of God will continue to sin, because God's seed remains in them. They cannot go on sinning because they have been born of God. Furthermore, let's read this. 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 17 clearly states, I gave you three versions, okay? Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creature has come, the old is gone, the new is here. This means that anyone who belongs to Christ has become a new person. The old life is gone, a new life has begun. So therefore, it's saying, Robbie, that you should be transfigured into something you're not. You should be something that reflects Christ's life, and nobody is seeing it in you. Because what you show us is hate, vulgarness, filthiness, perversion, many, many things, including absolute disgusting behavior. That is not Christ-like.
But I want to remind you of in your Bible, because they keep saying, you need to repent, and you need to read your Bible, not rip it up. Well, since yours are not ripped up, can you please turn your pages to Matthew 7? It says, do not judge, or you too will be judged. For in the same way you judge others, you will be judged. And with the measure you use, it will be measured to you. So why do you look at the speck of sawdust in your brother's eye and pay no attention to the plank in your own eye? So I want you to focus on the part where it says, for in the same way you judge others, you will be judged.
Well, guys, I will explain that exact scripture in detail. But first, let's continue to hear from Robbie just a little bit more.
So a lot of people say, well, I'm fighting for God, or I'm in the army of God, and I have to tell these people this, and I have to do that. That's great. But, you know, as any salesperson does, anybody who's trying to sell something to somebody, I don't think you're going to sell a car or Girl Scout cookies or Mary Kay makeup or whatever it is you're trying to sell if you're attacking the person and telling them what's wrong with them and that they need the product. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's not an effective way.
So Robbie has issue with the way somebody would approach them with the scripture. Of course, in some cases, you're going to be more loving, and in other cases, you should be more harsh. In Robbie's case, you should be very harsh because he's stubborn and he doesn't want to hear the truth. Allow me to remind you that the Lord tells us to go forth boldly and teach boldly, not softly, gently. We're not selling a product here, Robbie. We are selling absolutely nothing. God is commanding. That's the difference. We are instructed to even stand under rooftops and shout out the name of the Lord and call people to repent. That, my friend, is a fact. But once again, you have deniability because you wash away the scriptures as if they're just kind of corrupted or some man-made book. That's called a cop-out. Push away the word of God so you don't have to answer for anything.
So you're not a very smart representative of Christ. I know that I am because I know I'm imperfect and everybody else is. And I accept that that's how it is, and we're here to learn.
First off, Robbie, you said you read the Bible twice. I personally don't believe that, okay? I've been reading the Bible my whole life. Let me tell you this. Open up the book of Acts. The apostles never ever led with, oh, how much God loves you, how much Jesus loves you. Now, these guys were the Lord's disciples. They were his apostles. If anyone got teaching right, I'm sure they did. And every time they started out, they called people to repent. They called people to fear God. They never came up and said, by the way, my name is Peter and Jesus loves you. That did not happen. They started out with repentance and then they told you how to become saved. So for you to say that the approach that I take or other people take is wrong and incorrect and will catch less flies with vinegar, that's what you're trying to say, right? Well, Apostle Peter, Apostle Paul, all these apostles in the book of Acts did not teach the way you say I should teach. In fact, they called people to repent. Once people repented, then they told them a way to become saved and get salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ. That, my friend, is a fact. Then you say that you are a good representative of Christ because you're a sinner and you have that in you and you know how to basically, you know where everybody else is coming from. That's essentially what you're saying. That, my friend, is a cop-out because you do not teach of repentance. You do not teach to turn from your sin. In fact, you double down on it. You're a horrible example of what to be out there in the world preaching. Horrible. Why? Because when people look to you, they want to see a reflection of Jesus on how you act, how you behave, how you speak, and how you treat people. Your doctrine, Robbie, is actually this. If somebody treats me horrible, I'm going to treat them horrible. If somebody hates me, I'll hate them right back and I'll double it. This is nonsense. This is not biblical. This is not Christian. This is not associated with Jesus Christ in any way whatsoever. You, my friend, are a fraud. I do not see the beam of Jesus' love flowing from you whatsoever. In fact, I see Satan in the flesh. It was just the other day you dragged a dead woman. And a while back before that, you dragged MRB's son, who passed. And you're supposed to be saved, Robbie. Robbie has yet been saved. That's my whole point. You are a walking contradiction to the scriptures. So, Robbie, where does it say in the scriptures that if somebody hurts you, you can hurt them right back? It doesn't. In fact, the Lord says, vengeance is mine, says the Lord. Turn the other cheek. There's so many examples that you do not even bother to follow. Now, Robbie, before you say an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth, remember what Jesus said. Jesus said, you have heard it said, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. But I tell you, you shall bring no harm to any man. I listen to enough of your lives to hear the perversion that comes out of your mouth. The absolute filth of perversion. You speak about the most sexual, disgusting things I've ever heard of. You're an absolute deviant of the truth. Then you'll turn around and say, oh, the pastor hurt my feelings. Maybe he shouldn't preach so hard or so direct. No, Robbie, you need to hear a tough love. You need to hear the strict truth. You need to hear the fear of the Lord. If not, my friend, you are not going to end up in a place that you will regret for eternity. The same thing with Siren. He's a filthy slob of a human being. He's an absolute pig. He's a tyrant who walks with two legs. This man is a spoof of everything that is good. He is directly and indirectly evil. And guess what? Siren will end up exactly where you will go. Do you know why? Because he follows you around like a lost puppy. Now, let's read it together. Okay, guys, the only thing that Robbie is actually correct on is the actual reading of it, not the interpretation of it. So let's go over this line by line and let's see where we end up. Do not judge, or you too will be judged. For in the same way you judge others, you will be judged. And with the same measure you use, it will be measured unto you. So what Jesus is saying, he's not saying don't judge. What he's saying, if you judge, you better not be doing the same things that person is doing. For example, if someone's committing adultery, I shouldn't be committing adultery. If I am, I shouldn't call that person out and tell him to turn from his wicked ways and stop doing what he's doing. That's exactly what that scripture means. And to prove it, let's continue. Why do you look at the speck of sawdust in your brother's eye and pay no attention to the plank in your own eye? So the plank represents sin. So basically, how can I call somebody out of a sinful life or doing sin when I too am doing the same exact sins or I'm living a sinful life? So that's what Christ means. Take the plank out of my own eye first. Now I can see clearly. Let's continue. How can you say to your brother, let me take the speck out of your eye when at the same time you have a plank in your own eye? In other words, if I'm living a life full of sin, I have no right to speak on anything, right? Doesn't that make sense? But if I remove the plank from my eye, which will be the next line, if I actually remove sin from my life, That would make me righteous under God, in a sense. That God says, okay, well, you're not living a life of sin. You have a right to call it out. So, for the next line. You hypocrite. First take the plank out of your own eye, meaning stop living a sinful life, and then you will see clearly to remove the speck from your brother's eye. See, when it's put in his right perspective, Jesus isn't saying don't judge. What Jesus is saying, become righteous in the law, righteous in truth, righteous in spirit, and then you can call out sin in a spiritual sense. That's what Christ is saying. So when Robbie says, nobody should judge, you have no right to judge, or whatever, he's actually wrong. Let the Holy Spirit or the Scriptures itself interpretate the Scriptures. That's the way it works. So in actual fact, Jesus isn't saying, don't judge. What Jesus is saying, you can judge, but you got to make sure that you're in a righteous position to do so. So that's very important. So there you go, guys. Just from Matthew itself, what Jesus is saying, you can judge. So whenever I make a judgment call and some people, the scoffers I call them, put a comment in saying, the Bible says you can't judge. That's not true. Absolutely not true. And I hope I proved in this passage, but let's continue on. It's important. Okay, guys, line upon line, precept upon precept, a little here, a little there, proves what I'm trying to say. Now, we just read Matthew chapter 7, verse 1 to 6. We just read it, and it clearly shows that Jesus is saying that we can judge, but we must judge righteously. Okay, and look what Proverbs says. Open your mouth, judge righteously, defend the rights of the poor and needy. Nonetheless, guys, he's saying judge. Corinthians chapter 2, verse 15. The spiritual person judges all things, but is himself to be judged by no one. Other words, if I'm not living a sinful life, how can you judge me? Makes sense, right? But you can judge if you're coming from a righteous position. Let's continue. Leviticus. You shall not judge injustice in court. Other words, false represent. You shall not be partial to the poor or defer to the great. Other words, be neutral. But in righteousness shall you judge your neighbor. Other words, you can view what somebody is doing in their life, whether it's on YouTube or whether it's your friend down the road. If he's in error, he's in error, and you can call him on it. In fact, the Scriptures insist to make a righteous judgment. So there you go, guys. Line upon line, precept upon precept, a little here, a little there. I hope you understand where I'm coming from. So there you have it, guys. That's exactly what the good book says. So enough of this, people who come in and say, you can't judge. The Bible says don't judge. That's not true. Save Robbie and Siren wear their sin as a badge of honor. That's what they do. That's a big difference here, guys. Thank you for watching the video, and I hope finally I can lay this to rest. We can judge if we're coming from a righteous position. Anyhow, guys, God bless, and see you on the next one.